In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install Magic 360 on your website. If we come to the main product page, you can see our example spins 360 degrees, so you can see the product from every angle. And there's also a magnify option, so you can see the product in detail. We're going to begin the installation by downloading the free demo, which is a zip file. We'll open the folder where the zip file has been downloaded to. And we need to extract the files. You can use ISAC for this if you don't currently have anything. The folder we'll be uploading is the Magic 360 folder. In here, you can see we have the CSS and JavaScript files, which we'll be referencing later. There's also an images folder. We provided example images of a handbag and a shoe. You'll notice in the shoe folder, the images have been saved as what it is. So in this case, a shoe. The size of the image. We have two sizes. The 360 reference is a small image that will appear on your website. And the 800 reference is a large version of the image, which will be used for the magnifier option. You'll also notice each size has been saved in numerical order. This is known as a column, and the column reflects the left and right movement of the spin. You should label the column part of your images in the order you want them to appear on your website. If we have a look at the bag images, you'll notice they too have small and large versions, but they also have an extra set of numbers. This is for the row, and the row controls the up and down movement of your spin. You can see there is 1, 2, 3, and 4. This means your image will move up and down 4 positions on your web page. Again, notice how each set of row images also has a column information, and they're again in numerical order. I'll show you an example of this in a moment. First, we need to upload the Magic 360 folder to your server. I'm working locally, so I'll just paste a folder to my computer, but you'll need to upload the Magic 360 folder to your server. Next, we'll go to the integration page, which will tell us how to install Magic 360. There's two ways to do this, either with the Magic 360 wizard or manually. Let's look at the wizard first. You can see here we've told it how many columns we have and how many rows for the image. Further down you can see the file name. This is the name of our small image. And magnify file name is the image reference for our large image. You can see the small image is the same reference that we've just been looking at. But rather than listing each image that will appear, we can simply change the row numbers to row and the column numbers to col. This will pick up each of your images. So when I spin the image, that's picking up the column references. And when I move the image up and down, that's picking up the row references. You can see below the wizard two boxes with code in them. When you apply changes to the wizard, the code will update in these boxes. For example, the image has a magnify option. You can see in the code, magnify is set to true. If we change the wizard setting to false and click apply, you can see the image no longer has a magnify option. And the code now shows magnify as false. You can use either piece of code. The top box is the rel attribute code, so you can copy and paste this in your file. Or you can use the script tag. It's completely up to you. For today's example though, I'm going to manually install Magic 360. So if we go back to the integration page, you can see under detailed install, there is some code. If you have no code on your page, then you can copy all of this. I have some code already on my page, so I'm going to just copy the head code first and paste it into the head section of my file. I'm using Dreamweaver MX for this example. You can see the CSS file is referenced here and the JavaScript file is referenced here. If you ever move these files on your server, you'll need to update the location here in the head section, otherwise Magic 360 won't work. Next, we need to copy the body code and paste it within the body section of our file. The H reference is for the magnify image, which we'll come back to shortly. There's the Magic 360 class. The file name will pull in all your images. I'm using the shoe reference, so I'll just update that. And the col reference will pull all your images in numerical order. And the final reference is image source, which will be the image that appears on my web page. Don't forget, if you've saved your images in a folder, you'll need to reference it here. Now, if we preview our code, you can see the auto spin is defaulted to one spin, which can be changed. You can also drag the image to turn it or use your mouse wheel. So that's a 360 spin. Now let's add the magnifier option. You can either select the magnifier link here or go straight to section 5 magnifier from the anchor links at the top of the page. To add the magnifier option to our image, we need href image reference, which is our large image, the magnifier true attribute, and the magnifier file name. So I'll copy those and paste them after my existing rel attribute. Enter the correct magnifier file name, not the location, just the file name here. And enter the first large image that will appear and its location. This should be the large version of the small image on your web page. Now when we preview, you can see an icon has appeared which gives the option to magnify or spin. And that's how you install Magic 360. For more ideas on how you can display Magic 360 on your website, go to the Magic 360 examples page. Whatever changes you want to make, the Magic 360 integration page has all the HTML code you require. If you don't already have your 360 degree photos for your products, we can help. We have a photography service, so contact us for a free quote. At the top of each page on our website is a contact us link. So if you have any questions to do with Magic 360 or any of our other tools, just get in touch. If we're not online when you send your message through, we'll get back to you the very next day. And that brings us to the end of this tutorial. Thanks for watching.